there's a showdown in BPI Julia Vargas between Senator Trillanes and the front runner Rodrigo Duterte on his bank account. What should Duterte do?
Show the contents of his bank accounts. Siguro yun ang hamon at yun ang dapat gawin ng sino mang tumatakbo bilang pangulo, lalo na bilang pangulo. Bilang mayor nga siguro, bilang konsehal, ganun din ang dapat gawin, especially bilang pangulo ng bansa. Pag may tanong, dapat sagutin. Pag may issue, dapat ipaliwanag. Now, utang niya sa kanyang supporters yun at sa ating lahat.
I'm curious, Duterte in a press conference said he got millions as a birthday gift. Has that ever happened to you?
I wish also, sana.
Should you declare millions, I mean, in your salon? If there are birthday gifts that you spend after, I'm curious.
That's a loophole in our salon law. Kasi ang nakalagay sa salon law, cash in hand as of December 31. So kung pumasok, lumabas in the course of the year, wala kang obligasyon under the salon law to declare what went in and what went out. Your declaration under the salon law is, what was your balance at the end of the year as of December 31? Isang loophole yon na kailangan nating punuan.
All right. Now, let's talk about their campaign. I mean, your particular race. You were number one for a long period of time. And suddenly, during the last stretch of the campaign, we're seeing a change. Bongbong Marcos has overtaken you in the last Pulse Asia survey. He's at 31. Lenny Robredo, who started, I think, with a 4%, is now number two. How were you feeling without the surveys? I mean,
Ganyan talaga yung survey, Karen. Vice President Binay was also way ahead in the beginning. And then Senator Po went past him, held it for quite some time, and now it's Mayor Duterte. That's really how a survey is run. Usually, it's like a wheel. Minsan nasa taas ka, minsan nasa baba ka. Ang importante, sa pag-ikot ng gulong, sino ang nasa taas sa araw ng eleksyon? Another way of saying it is peaking at the right time, so to speak. Some will peak after the elections, some will peak ahead of the elections. The key is how to peak on the day of the election itself.
Do you believe the Pulse Asia survey?
I believe the worst survey in so far as we are concerned. Di ba? Yung pinakamalalang survey laban sa amin ni Senator Grace, yun ang dapat namin paniwalaan. Alam ka naman, lokohin namin yung sarili namin na yung pinakamagandang survey lang ang papaniwalaan namin. The surveys may be good, the surveys may be bad. We may be faring well in the surveys on some days, faring not so well on some other days. But as a rule, we should listen to, heed, and follow, and take... look at it seriously, the worst survey against Senator Grace and against myself.
Now, what do you think happened? I'm curious. I mean, based on your analysis, do you and Senator Grace have a messaging issue with the public? I mean, both of you were number one for a long period of time. And then suddenly, you have a major shift. Now, Duterte is raking in numbers in 34s. So what do you think happened? Was your message not clear?
It's not so much messaging, Karen, as the ability to get it across. I think all of the candidates have a good message. Each one has their own respective corner or place under the sun that they want to focus on. It's a matter of enabling that message to come across. At the end of the day, if you look at them for the first time, each election is unique, by the way. Walang eleksyong pareho. Kung tingnan mo yung advertisements ng mga kandidato, it's flat. Walang nakapag-advertise na nag-breakaway. Na yung advertisement niya really cut across and really touched a sensitive nerve or core. It's all about news and it's all about sound bites. It's all about your footprint in the news and recall being given to the voters.
Now, why don't you hit Senator Bongbong Marcos? I mean, people who have seen you in the debates have asked, what happened to Senator Chiz Escudero? I mean, he fought against Gloria Arroyo. You know, he was always against corruption and he was always very vocal. And then people were waiting for you to just take a, you know, to criticize either for Bongbong to apologize, return hidden wealth, and they didn't hear it from you.
The basic difference, Karen, is I'm a candidate and he's a candidate too. And I'm running against him. In relation to former President Arroyo, I was not running against her and I was not a candidate. For you to fight for something, are you sure you're fighting that something because of your own personal interest, or is it because you're really fighting for an issue? When you're a candidate, everything will be put into doubt. But having said that, hindi ko man siya nilabanan, hindi ko man siya inaway, o tulad ng ibang mga kandidato, tinira. Ginawa ko yung trabaho ko para hindi na maulit pa yung nangyari nung panahon ng kanyang ama. Pinasa ko, ako ang author, anti-torture law. Pinasa ko, anti-involuntary disappearance law, yung desaparecidos. Pinasa ko rin yung Marcos compensation para sa human rights victims. Yung ibang tumitira sa kanya, yung ibang inaatake siya ngayon, wala namang ginawa kaugnay sa mga bagay na yun. Pero siyempre, panahon ng kampanyan, edi titira sila. Mas pipiliin ko na, Karen. Ginawa ko yung trabaho ko, pero nung panahon ng eleksyon, hindi ko gagamitin yon bilang plataforma para tirahin lamang yung katunggali ko.
But are you restrained in any way because your father used to work for Marcos?
No, not at all, Karen. My father has passed, and my father has always respected my own personal views with respect to politics. For example, yung tatay ko naghain ng resolusyon para payagan ang Marcos burial sa libingan ng mga bayani. Congressman siya noon, senador ako. Hindi ko ginawa yun sa Senado. Mm. Wala akong counterpart bill
so
at hindi ko sinuportahan.
So you don't believe,
yan.
If I were to ask you now, you don't believe that Marcos should be buried at the libingan ng mga bayani?
No. And if the
Why
Marcos...
Not? Why not?
Because if the Marcos family is really interested in doing that, they could have done something for the past 20 years. They have not. Kung ayaw ng gobyerno, ayaw ni GMA, ayaw ni Pangulo Aquino, they have good lawyers. They're rich enough to hire good lawyers. Why not file a petition before the Supreme Court and say, he should be buried there? Why haven't they lifted a finger? Mm-hmm. Kung talagang interesado silang gawin yun, may paraan para magawa yun. We cannot be more interested than they are in so far as doing this.
Now, in this administration, there's talk that it's time to shut down the PCGG. Do you believe it is time to stop recovering the ill-gotten wealth supposedly that is with the Marcoses? You think it's time to move on?
Perhaps if he becomes president, then that will happen. They will shut down PCGG because PCGG was created solely to run after the Marcos ill-gotten wealth. It's not yet over. The fight is not yet over, and there are still assets to run after. Ask any PCGG commissioner. Ask any PCGG former chairperson. The fight is still ongoing.
Mm. Now, Serge Osmeña and Lenny Robredo, when they were on Head Start, said if Bongbong Marcos wins, we would be the laughing stock of the world. Do you believe that to be true?
Laughing stock of the world, probably yes, because of the history that they know of. Unfortunately, Karen, it's the Filipinos who will get to choose. Whatever the world says doesn't so much matter as what the Filipino people says or will say. But having said that, let me say this. Whoever becomes president and vice president will be a minority president and vice president. They can or will win this with 35%. That means 65% of our people did not vote for them. 65% of our people don't like them, like someone else. Ang hamon sa susunod na pangulo siguro ng bansa, at ikalawang pangulo, paano mapag-isa yung bansa pagkatapos? Dahil kung simula pa lang, may aaway na. Mm. Kung simula pa lang, may kaaway na. Kung simula pa lang, may nagrarally na, ni wala pang honeymoon na binibigay sa mga leader natin, paano po natin mapag-iisa yung ating bansa?
Now, are you misunderstood? Do you think people misunderstand who you are? I mean, your critics have called you so young pero trapo sa cheese. He's a traditional politician. I mean, do you feel you're misunderstood?
That's why they're called critics, Karen. You can never make everybody happy in anything and everything you say. At the end of the day, sa isang demokrasya, palagi may kritiko. Sa isang demokrasya, palagi may pupuri din sa'yo. It has never been my objective to please the rich. It has never been my objective to please class ABC or those with huge holdings in the stock market. No. And they're usually the ones that are heard.
Mm. All right. Now, what will happen to the Philippines if Duterte wins?
I honestly do not know. It's going to be an exciting challenge every day of the week.
Do you think Senator Grace Poe can still, you think she can still pull the numbers? Right now in the latest Pulse Asia, she's at 22. Let's take that as a basis. Mm-hmm. Duterte was at 34. I mean, you're a person that's very good with numbers. Historically speaking, has it been done?
Of course, Karen. It has been done. It has happened many times over. Surveys, again, I assume all surveys are correct. Let me clarify that. But surveys have been known also to change and shift in a matter of days. For example, in 2010, the run for the presidency, all the surveys said that ERAP would place a far third to President Aquino. ERAP ended up a relatively close second to President Aquino. The last survey 10 days before the election showed Secretary Rojas 12 points ahead of Vice President Binay. Vice President Binay ended up winning it by 1.5%.
Yeah.
The surveys
Arab was 10 million, I think.
The surveys in 2004 showed GMA winning by a wide margin over Metro Manila. FPJ won over GMA by over 10% in Metro Manila.
So you believe sometimes surveys, not that they're wrong, but they can change a few days before the actual day.
Exactly, Karen. Because if you look at the surveys themselves, about 20% of our people are still so-called soft voters. They will make their decision on the day of the election itself, whose name to shade. So if you're talking of a lead of 9%, 5%, 11%, 12%, you're talking of 20% who will decide on the day itself. So it can matter, it can still change. At the end of the day, that's why you count the votes, not the surveys. And if you look at the latest survey today, that was taken a week before. So at least there's a week's lag in so far as that result is concerned. If you take a survey even today, and it comes out a few days before the election, that's still a week-old survey. Mm.